have a question for him, please put it in the chat. All right, go ahead, Jordan Hill.
Well, I want to go back to a couple of years ago when you first got here with Derek and Marlon still being here. What did you kind of learn from those guys just about, you know, what you had to do and sort of the preparation that it takes to play it off?
We just pretty much, you know, practice every play like it's your last, work hard. I learned to, you know, approach the game how you want, approach practice how you want to play in the game, which is what I do now. Practice every day, hustle, effort, give it all, play like I'm playing on Saturday. So that way when the game comes, you know, I'm ready for it. Coach has a saying, practice performance equals game reality, and that's 100% true. What you do in practice is what you'll do in the game. You're building habits, so just that.
Right, our next question is from Nathan King.
Colby, how much does it motivate you guys and the rest of that defensive front when Zacoby is kind of having the game like he had on Saturday?
It just motivates us a lot, you know. See one of our linebackers behind us flying around, making all those plays, making those tackles. Just motivates us to, you know, get back there and get a sack or flush him too, flush the quarterback too, Zacoby. It's just real electric when he makes a hit, or just, you know, simply he's out there with us. Brings a lot of energy, you know, Ricochet Rabbit. I love playing with him.
All right, go ahead, Jason Caldwell.
It's you know, it's very helpful. We know how to stay in our gap, play our keys, read our keys, and, you know, play physical. That's what Coach preached all last week and keeps preaching. The most physical team wins. So for us, we just got to not do nothing different. Just keep playing physical, keep standing in our gaps, doing our playing our responsibilities, and, you know, seeing our keys and reacting.
Alvaro Torres.
Hi, Colby. I hope you're having a great day. Well, is it fair to call Zay Spiller one of the best running backs in this class? And how does practicing with great backs, as the ones you have every week, help you prepare for such an elite player?
Well, Spiller's a great back. Just, you know, practicing with some of our backs, Tank and Jarquez, you know, it just allows us, you know, to see what an SEC back is going to look like on Saturday. You can't replicate how elusive and how, you know, how good Spiller is. So, you know, just seeing those guys every day in practice allows us to, you know, to see our keys, you know, read, react, and just do what we're supposed to do. Stay in our gaps and, you know, do what we're supposed to do.
All right, up next is Philip Marshall.
What brought me to Auburn, I'd have to say the family environment, as well as Coach G. You know, Coach G, knowing what he, you know, at the time, you know, he had produced a lot of people and put a lot of people in the league and coached up well, and just done a great job with D-line until then. And my time now has been fun, you know. Learned freshman year, sitting down, learning from Derek and Marlon, you know, taking time to, you know, see how to approach the game, how to play it. And then last year, you know, kind of dipping my toe in, you know, getting acclimated, you know, seeing how SEC ball is, how fun it can be. Pretty much just like last year was like almost refining your love for the game. You know, coming from high school, being that guy to, you know, freshman year sitting down to last year playing, and you're winning, you know, it's fun. To this year, you know, we just keep getting better and better as the week goes on. So my time here has been great, to say the least, you know.
All right, we have a follow-up from Jordan Hill.
Well, we had a chance to talk with Coach Shells at Archer about you, and he talked about your junior year at
I remember like coming off on my shoulder, like I don't know what happened. I like hit the dude and my shoulder popped out of place, and it felt funny. I'm like, this don't feel weird, but whatever. So I'm like running with it, like flapping in the wind. And I would try to go. I'd have got there and blocked the kick, but the dude fumbled the ball, so ended up being tackled back there. But yeah, so I had dislocated my shoulder, and then when like the doctor said, you know, we'll put a brace on, you'll be able to play. Let's go. So that following playoff game, I had like my best performance ever, with like 3 sacks and crazy amount of tackles. So I don't know, it was just fun. I couldn't leave my boys.
All right, we have a question from Nevaeh Wilborn.
Kobe, how you doing, sir?
Good, how are you?
Man, bless your holiday favorite, man. Can't complain about nothing, man. This thing will be alive. Two-parter. One, did you watch that old baseball game last night? And then, tell me what your thoughts about that, but also going up against Texas A&M's defensive line. What have you kind of noticed about that group?
So, of course, you know, being from Georgia, you know, had to watch my Braves go and win something, you know, had to bring it home for us. That was exciting to watch. They did great, great win on the road, get it done on the road, and bring it on home for Atlanta. You know, Atlanta's going to be crazy. It's already full of traffic, but this week, crazier. Going against Texas A&M, I think the biggest goal for us is we got to, like I said earlier, just, you know, play our keys and stay in our gaps. The backs are patient, so we got to, you know, stay there. Run. Biggest thing for us, get knocked back. Get knocked back on the linemen. And once we get knocked back on the linemen, we'll be able to stay in our gaps, read, react, and just, you know, make the plays, because that's what the backs want to do. They want to come downhill, be patient, and let you get out your gap so they can attack where you're not. So we just got to do our job and play physical, and we should be fine.
All right. Our last question will be from Jason Caldwell.
Kobe, when Marcus Harris got on campus, he said you were one of the guys that kind of took him under your wing a little bit, and that's a guy that potentially you might have been competing for. So what did you see out of him that made you realize we're going to need this guy right away?
I seen how hard he works. I seen the desire, the hunger. I love playing beside him. I know I got a partner in crime who's gonna be out there with me and ride with me. He's gonna do his job, do what we asked, and do more. So it's just great, you know, playing with somebody who has exceptional pad level, strong as an ox, and knows the game, and cares about it as much as I do. So that's just, you know, fun to have, and I love playing beside him.
All right, that'll do it for Colby.